21 and 5.
Yeah, okay.
I've got it.
3.
Mm-hmm.
Three.
I thought the mean was like the biggest number take away the smallest number, and I was clearly confused.
And then, oh no, it can't be right.
I usually like to stick to something that I know and how I know to do it.
Yeah. When I was trying to work out like the mode and the mean, like I didn't understand them.
There was quite a few errors and numbers and a bit too much for me. It takes me, I probably could understand it, but it takes me a bit more time.
You have to divide that by 2 because it's 2 times more than a drink. Yeah. I get what I mean, but yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I know what I mean, Lars. I don't know how to word it.
Students studying to resit their mathematics GCSE. Their aim is to improve their attainment, and the aim of this research programme, Exploring Mastery in FE, is to find out how best to help them. The belief that everyone can succeed in mathematics underpins a mastery approach. That includes our GCSE resit students. But, as teachers tell us, there are challenges.
In 11 years of school maths education, the confidence level of our students is so low, they don't believe they could ever understand something, make sense of it, or communicate it.
These students have got 11 or 12 years of stuff that they've picked up and not properly internalised, and now they're trying to kind of get it out again.
The thing is, by getting through everything, they've been through that at school, but we can teach it differently. So, could you tell me anything else about some statistics?
We need to know what works in teaching for mastery. To find evidence of what works involves teachers taking part in the research.
Can I leave you to discuss whether this is also okay and why? Is that okay? Can you try and explain?
We're now starting to realise there's something going wrong at this point.
It's a national research programme involving teachers in colleges from across the country. The next phase of the programme offers more teachers the opportunity to take part. To learn more, here are some observations from those already involved in this or similar projects connected with the University of Nottingham. These are teachers who have been exploring approaches that give students opportunities to explore their understanding of important ideas in mathematics.
I was interested because it was resets, it was GCSE, it was the learners that feel a little bit abandoned, which was the reason I got involved with the project.
The teachers talk here about their experience of this kind of research.
Hello, my name is Julian Collings and I work at CfEM College.
Hi, my name's Mark from Harlow College.
Hi, I'm Richard Kirtland. I'm an RML on the Centres for Excellence in Maths project.
I've enjoyed the opportunity it provided to try something new without judgment.
It's helped me open up my classroom more and myself to enable learners to participate in the learning rather than just be a bucket for the stuff I know. So it's really been enlightening.
My students have benefited from new ways of teaching in terms of motivation and engagement. It was all about communication. It was about them talking to each other and explaining their thinking to each other.
It was gold dust being able to observe learners having conversations about the lesson that you would not be privy to if you were stood at the front of the classroom.
On a personal note, it's great to reflect on your own practice and learn from others.
I think this allows for the whole team to progress and become better at what we do.
My college is driving for professional learning communities. Well, that's exactly what this is.
I think it's an opportunity to be part of something bigger. It's an opportunity to seek out and build your own professional network. It's an opportunity to reflect on your own teaching, improve your own teaching, and build a collaborative group amongst local teachers as well as national teachers.
It's really interesting that, isn't it?
Because it's probably the best CPD I've ever done.
I felt it was the best PD I'd ever done.
It's been great fun, and I've really enjoyed it.
Times are changing, and maybe our teaching needs to change too. Do we need to do some more collaborative group work? Do our lessons need to be more visual? Do we need to use some more digital resources? Well, the only way we're going to find out is if we experiment. And that's why it's important to contribute to research that will ultimately benefit us as teachers and our learners.
It will allow us to revisit our own practice and ultimately will have a positive impact on all our learners in FE.
And this is a maths development programme to improve teaching and learning, to help learners think for themselves.
Why would you not want to be involved in something like that?
What we so often don't get is an opportunity to talk about what we do in maths lessons.
Was there anything in particular that happened in the lesson that made you change your mind?